हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी डिस्कस अबाउट द गिफ्ट ऑफ स्पीच। पैसेज राइटिंग है, ओके। सबसे पहले हम इसका पैसेज पढ़ते हैं। स्पीच इज ग्रेट फ्लैशिंग बट इट कैन ऑल्सो बी अ ग्रेट कर्स फॉर वायलिंग। It helps us to make our intentions and desires known to our fellows. It can also, if we use to carelessly, make our attitude completely misunderstood. A slip of the tongue, the use of unusual or an ambiguous word and so on many create an enemy where we had helped to win a friend. Again, different classes of people use different vocabularies and the ordinary speech of an educated man may strike an uneducated listener as showing pride. Unwillingly, we may use a word which bears a different meaning for our listener from what it does to men of our own class. As a speech is not a gift to use lightly without thought, but one which demands careful handling. Okay, अब इसके हम पढ़ेंगे पैसेज। Speech is a great gift given to me by nature, but it can be a great curse also. It helps us in our communication with one another, but if used carelessly, it can create misunderstanding also. A slip of tongue or the use of an ambiguous word may make our friend an enemy of us. The tone of our speech may make us misunderstood by other. So the gift of speech should be carefully handled. Iska title hai The suitable title suggested to the passage is the gift of speech. Next passage padhenge. English is today studied because of its commercial and so-called political value. Our voice think and rightly in the present circumstances that without English day. Cannot get government service. Girl are thought English as a passport of marriage. I know several instances of women wanting to learn English so that they may be able to talk to Englishmen in English. I know husbands who are sorry that their wives cannot talk to them and their friends in English. I know families in which English is being made the mother tongue. Hundreds of youths believe that without a knowledge of English, progress of India is practically impossible. The canker has so eaten into the society that in many cases, the only meaning of education is your knowledge of English. All these are for me signs of our slavery and degradation. I cannot tolerate the idea of parents writing to their children, husband writing to their wives not in their mother tongue but in English. I would have our young men and women with literary taste learn as much of English and other world languages as they like and then expect them to give the benefits of their life. To India and to the world like a ghost of terror, but I would not have a single Indian to forget, neglect or be ashamed of his mother tongue, or to feel that he or she cannot think or express the best thought in his or her own mother tongue. Iski precise hai, there is no doubt that English has got its commercial and political value today. It has its value in family life also. All parents want their children to learn English so that they can converse in English and get a good job. There is no denying that one should learn English and other languages as much as one can, but one should not neglect one's mother tongue or feel ashamed of using it in daily life, or feel that one cannot express oneself in one's own language effectively. Iska title hai the suitable title suggested to the passage may be the importance of English, ya fir English as a medium of expression. Okay, next passage. Character is the base of every man's life. It is the backbone of our existence. A man who has no character can get no mental or spiritual attainment. M.K. Gandhi attained higher things and Gautam Buddha found a rare gift in his life on account of character. Character is like a touchstone which converts even a waste metal into gold. In India, corruption can be easily observed in various fields of life. In the field of public administration, there is an utter lack of character. Bribe is a gladly accepted why those power and dishonesty is supposed to be part of practical wisdom. Duty is regarded as secondary and personal gains as primary. Iski passage hai, character is the backbone of our life. No man can get peace and success without character. Great men like Gandhiji and Buddha could ride high in life because of their character, but India today is faced with a crisis of character in politics and public administration. Dishonesty and corruption have become a part and parcel of our life. The suitable title suggested to the passage, A Crisis of Character in India. Next day, speaking in a public is as difficult as singing or acting, and it ought to have quite a careful rehearsals, even more careful, because one of the aims of the public speaker is to appear entire, spontaneous. The great speakers of Greece and Rome used to prepare an important speech as carefully as an opera star nowadays studies a new role. After writing it out a dozen times, they would deliver it before a few trusted friends, critics and tutors, repeating it again until they knew every syllable and gesture, and yet the whole thing appeared not a highly elaborate product of art, but a genuine outpouring of a real and overwhelming emotions. इसका प्रेशर है, मेकिंग अ पब्लिक स्पीच इज अ डिफिकल्ट आर्ट, इट रिक्वायर्स केयरफुल रिहर्सल्स लाइक सिंगिंग एक्टिंग फॉर स्पॉन्टेनियस ऑरेशन. द ग्रीक एंड रोमन स्पीकर्स कुड मेक एन इमोशनल अपील बिकॉज दे प्रिपेयर देयर स्पीच विद लेवर एंड रिहर्सल्स. The speech of men like have a relevance even today because his speech contain deep thoughts, a keen psychological insight, and skilled language. A single page of them contains the result of more concentrated thought, active experience, intricate psychological knowledge, and training. Language than most modern speakers can command in a whole life time. इसका टाइटल है द सुटेबल टाइटल सजेस्टिव टू द पैसेज इज द आर्ट ऑफ पब्लिक स्पीकिंग. Speaking in public is as difficult as singing or acting, and it ought to have quite a careful rehearsals, even more careful, because one of the aims of the public speaker is to appear entirely spontaneous.